it's really hard for me to say right now. I feel terribly, you know, the politicians have failed, the entire country have failed. You know, the country is completely shut off. The economy, it stopped completely.
Hi, this is Vincent Shkreli from the Daily Caller News Foundation. I'm speaking with Matteo Rizzardi, a citizen in Italy. He's there to speak with us about the quarantine situation. How are you, Matteo?
Hi, how are you? Hi, everybody. I'm good.
So
now.
So firstly, how is the situation in Italy? We know that there's a nationwide quarantine.
The general situation is obviously it's total panic. It's a situation of psychosis. Everybody's scared. Everything happens so fast. The situation in northern Italy about hospitals, you know, the sanity is collapsing up there, and which is a very bad sign for us, because in the region of Lombardia, in Milan, those places, those are the places where we actually have the best hospitals, and the sanity is collapsing up there. So I don't want to imagine how's it going to be when the virus is going to go on the southern part of Italy, from Rome to Sicily, Naples, those kind of places. In general, you know, as I said before, it's something that we was kind of expecting. A couple of hours ago, I heard the WHO declare the pandemic situation.
A global pandemic?
It's not going to be just a problem of our country. It's going to be something that's going to touch everybody else's. And I think people are going to be worried about that in the next days. So it's not just an Italian problem.
What precautions have other people that you know, especially yourself, have taken in order to stay away, to stay safe from the virus?
The precaution that we need to respect, because if there's a ministerial decree that says that you have to stay home, you have to stay home. There's no party, there's no movies, there's no shopping. And that's one of those problems, because people really hardly understand that we are facing a very, very, very bad problem. And we need to stay calm. We need to obviously respect those hygienic precautions, you know, washing hands. I don't even think that putting a mask would be useful, honestly. You know, we have to stay home. We need to stay calm. If we have some fever, some flu, we have to call the doctor and not going right away to the hospital, because hospitals are full of people. You will see the lines of people waiting for a visit. And those are the most dangerous places to be, actually, hospitals, because you don't know who has this influence, who don't. So I think the best thing to do is to stay calm, staying with the family, trying to limit the times that you actually go out. If you go out, it has to be just because it's something that is necessary. So getting food, you know, go to the pharmacy, those kind of things. We need to stay together. We need to wait those 2 weeks, because those 2 weeks will be crucial for us. And we need to wait and see what happens, and not losing our minds, obviously. There are so many people in intensive care. By intensive care, I mean that the patients, the infected, are attached to a breathing machine. And the main problem is is that we don't have those machines for everybody. During those days, we had to face something like you don't want to see, some kind of things that you really see in sci-fi movies, or in scenarios of war where you actually have to choose between saving an 80-year-old guy and a 30-year-old guy. I think it's terrible. I my skin is flipping right now because I don't know the term. I don't know how you say that, but. It's really something you don't want to see. Choosing between that and that. Every life is important. It's really hard for me to say right now. I feel terribly, you know, the politicians have failed. The entire country have failed. The country is completely shut off. The economy, it stopped completely. You see empty streets in Rome, which is one of the most chaotic places in the entire world. And it's something we've never faced before. And I don't really know what else to say.
I just actually saw a photo of Campo de Fiori. It was completely empty. Is every city square? Is every part of Rome? I mean, I would take it that it's completely empty, every single part of the city.
Yeah, when we were actually there together, you remember how many people were there?
Yeah.
The different scenario. Mm-hmm. So 10,000 infected, 630 died, but the number are spreading while we're talking. So tomorrow we will have different numbers for sure. I really hope that Europe right now, it's really sounds like a joke right now, because they promised us some money to fight this problem, and till now this is just talking, because we have never received those money yet. We're still waiting, we're still fighting, especially the people in the hospitals, those heroes that wake up at 6 in the morning, 5 in the morning, 4 in the morning, and goes straight to the hospital to help those guys. Those are the real heroes right now, and they're probably the people that are more in danger, because you are there with all these infected people, and you don't know what's going to happen to you, but you work because you have heart, and that's the right thing to do in that moment. So, it's tough. It's really tough.
How has the Italian media been portraying the virus? Has it been, I know you're not in the States, but is it somewhat similar? If you've read articles or watched some news outlets from the States, probably online, is it somewhat similar, or is there a difference?
The main problem in Italy is in Italy, but in also other countries in the world, is the misinformation. Especially in Italy, every journal says something different. So if people are stuck in their homes, who do you believe? You believe that journal? You believe that? You believe the television? You don't really know. You don't really know what's happening. The only thing you can actually do is stay home and praying that everybody's gonna be solved as soon as possible. But I have a serious question mark about that. I don't really know how much time we will need to solve this. I'm really worried about the other countries that feel safe, because we are not the first country that have economic relationships with China. There are other countries that are more close to China, and I'm really worried about the U.S. as well, because with the sanitary system you have, it's it's not a free system. I heard that a coronavirus test cost like between $2,000 and $3,000. So I'm imagining an entire family infected that is worried and needs to do the test. They go to the hospital and then they say, okay, for five people, it's $10,000 for the just for the test. And if they are not able to afford that, how will this it's gonna end? So, but you know, going back to the question you made before about the information in the internet, you know, everybody says something different. So at the end of the day, you don't really know who to believe. And the only thing is to searching, speaking with the right people. I'm lucky to have journalists in my family, so I have those good supposed to be good informations, but you cannot know that. You don't really know that.
Do you think that the nationwide quarantine situation in Italy could possibly happen in the United States?
Absolutely, in the United States as well as many other countries. The Angela Merkel actually said a couple of hours ago, or this morning, I don't know when, that there's a big possibility that the 60% of the entire population will be infected. And I don't know that, I sincerely don't know that, but they probably have their own numbers, their own statistics, where they actually base those kind of sentences. So that's something that the Prime Minister of Germany said, so it's not something that Matteo is saying right now. Mm-hmm. There's a big possibility that this is going to happen. And I don't want to be catastrophic, but I think about the United States as the most close country to China for importing stuff, you know, economic relationships. Many people from China work there, lives there, make their own family there. So, you know, possibilities are everywhere. It's a virus. It goes. It's in the air. It's not something that we're actually able to control. So the only thing we can actually do is, as I said before, to stay calm, to be informed, and to respect the rules that our government tells us to respect. In this moment, many people have the risk to be in a very, very, very bad situation that you don't want to see.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Matteo.
Thank you, Vincent. I'll catch you later.
I'll see you soon.